Good evening, everybody. I'm Scott Banks, Professor in Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering, Interim Chair. It's my pleasure to serve as host of this evening's event. I would like to welcome everyone who is watching this evening's live video stream of the 2020 Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering Annual Awards Ceremony. We find ourselves in the most extraordinary of times, replacing a cherished annual event with an ambitious experiment in live, highly participatory celebration of the MAE community. Tonight's presentation involves contributions from over 30 individuals with speaking roles, either live or recorded, with technical and organizational contributions from many others. I hope you enjoy the proceedings and look forward to your feedback. I would note that this event will be available in a recorded format after our live broadcast, so that people may enjoy a closed caption version of the event. I'll begin tonight with a very brief summary of MAE highlights over the past year. We'll then have our keynote speaker and then jump into the awards portion of our event. It's been a very good year for MAE on many fronts. As everyone knows, UF has ascended to the rank of number 7 public university in the US, and our mechanical and aerospace engineering programs continued to be ranked among the top 15 or 16 public graduate programs, respectively. Our students continue to earn a huge number of degrees, with over 400 bachelor's, almost 200 master's, and over 30 PhD degrees in the past year, with notable strength in the number of degrees awarded to women mechanical and aerospace engineers and the number of degrees awarded to Hispanic engineers. Our research enterprise is on a great trajectory due to the hard work of our faculty and graduate students. One notable metric is that our new research awards for the 2019-2020 fiscal year are up over 30% from the previous year. Thank you to our faculty colleagues who are applying their creativity, expertise, and very hard work to win highly competitive and prestigious research awards. Along those lines, our faculty continue to achieve recognition for their teaching and scholarship, with many of our colleagues receiving fellow rank in professional societies, election to society leadership roles, and other notable accolades. Of particular note this year is that our own distinguished professor, Bala Balachander, received the 2019-2020 Doctoral Dissertation Advisor Mentoring Award for the entire University of Florida. And finally, our department has long been committed to vigorously experiential programs for our undergraduates as we support over 15 student-run design, build, compete, and professional practice teams and clubs. This year continued our tradition of MAE teams competing, placing, and winning in a wide array of regional and national competitions. In tonight's program, you're going to hear about a handful of these groups, see their activities, and hear their details of their accomplishments. It's also a great pleasure to welcome three new members to our faculty. Dr. Jing Pan joins MAE as an assistant professor. He obtained his PhD at Purdue University and completed his postdoctoral studies at Stanford before joining UF. Jing's research focuses on developing nanoscale machines for biotechnology applications. We also welcome Dr. Andreas Rubiano into MAE as a lecturer focused in our mechanical design and capstone courses. Andreas received his PhD here in MAE and completed his postdoctoral studies at the National Institutes of Health before returning here to join UF. Dr. Matt Tromm joins MAE as a senior lecturer and brings over a decade of prior experience in developing hands-on curricula for teaching thermofluids and design skills in mechanical engineering. Matt received his PhD from MIT. Matt and Andreas had the extra challenge this term, along with all of our design and lab instructors, of switching their courses from intensely hands-on and interactive to completely online and remote over the course of about 1 week's time. I had the pleasure of attending a number of our capstone design presentations and came away extremely impressed with what our colleagues and students were able to accomplish. We're so grateful for their efforts. So welcome, Jing, Andreas, and Matt. We are thrilled you have joined MAE and look forward to our future together. Before we embark on the festive aspects of our program, I wanted to take a moment to recognize a few members of the MA family that we've lost over the past year. Many of you came to know Jan Rocky, who served in our department for over 40 years. She retired last fall and unfortunately passed away shortly thereafter. Jan's work in the department formed many of our relationships, and she just had a profound, profound impact on all of us in MAE and is now sorely missed. Judy Shivers worked at the Reef and had a similar impact on the folks there supporting their activities over the past several decades. Over the past year, we lost Professors Emmanuel Parthenides, Nikolai Christescu, and Sung Liu, all of whom were luminaries in their field, cherished here in Gainesville, and respected worldwide for their activities and relationships in their fields. And very recently, we learned that we lost W.W. Bill Gay, one of our outstanding alumni and really a luminary in Central and North Florida. Bill founded W.W. Gay Contractors, the largest HVAC contracting group in this region of the United States. He was an extraordinary business owner, a gentleman, an incredible philanthropist that many students will recognize as having his name on our Student Design Center, as well as the endowment, the W.W. Gay Endowment, that supports so many of our student activities. All of these individuals will be missed sorely, and we think it fitting to recognize their contributions to our MAE community and that they will sorely be missed. It's now my pleasure to invite introduce tonight's keynote speaker, Jennifer Philibrand. In the past, we've invited distinguished alumni to present a keynote speech at our awards banquet. This year, we thought it would be great to have one of our distinguished senior undergraduates share her comments and perspectives. I'm so happy this year to introduce Jennifer Philibrand as our keynote speaker. Jennifer is a senior aerospace engineering student with a fabulous academic record who is last year's recipient of our All-Britain Scholarship. Midshipman First Class Jennifer Philibrand is a nuclear screen midshipman who will join the United States Submarine Force upon graduation. Of particular note, and because of her work in ROTC, academics, and our community, Jennifer was recently named the All-American Navy ROTC Student of the Year, the top Navy Marine ROTC student in the country. What a fabulous achievement that all of us in MAE and at UF can celebrate with Jennifer. When I asked Jennifer to consider sharing remarks at our awards banquet early this year, she graciously agreed. In fact, she mentioned that as she was listening to Bill Roto-Rooter give his remarks as last year's keynote speaker, Jennifer imagined that someday she might like to give a keynote speech. Well, our April 2nd banquet was canceled because of the pandemic, but it gives me great pleasure today to share Jennifer's comments in our online award ceremony.
Hi, my name is Jennifer Philibrand, and I'm a senior here at University of Florida. I'm one semester away from graduating with a degree in aerospace engineering. Over the last couple of weeks, I've taken some time to reflect on how I got here and what I've learned. One of the things that got me interested in engineering was working on my car with my dad. Though you could probably say that working on is a little bit of an overstatement. But I can change my own oil and my tires completely by myself. Really, I just fetch tools. My dad taught me that the right tool is key to getting a job done efficiently, but the real skill is in selecting and applying them, and being able to read a car manual or look up a YouTube video, of course. I loved learning how to work on my car and modify it to be exactly the way I wanted it. The only reason that my old car runs today is because of the countless hours that my dad and I put into making sure that it runs like a well-oiled machine. Understanding how my car works gave me a sense of control and appreciation for driving like nothing else. That's what engineering does for me. It heightens my ability to appreciate daily life, and that's why I wanted to study it more. When I was a junior in high school, I was overwhelmed by the numbers of colleges, universities, and engineering programs to choose from. I didn't know how I, as a high school student, was supposed to pick the best college for me, having never been to college. So I focused on one thing that I knew was very important to me, sunshine. I'm from Southern Maryland, and I really, really hate the cold. So I only applied to one school where there was even a possibility of snow, and the rest were in Florida or Southern California. When it came time to choose between Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University and University of Florida, I honed in on another crucial factor, the availability of shade. It's true, I chose my university based on the climate and some really cool trees, and I got incredibly lucky to be at one of the top public universities in the country, top 7 to be exact, with world-class dedicated faculty and every resource that I need to succeed. When I got to college, everyone would ask me the same 2 questions. What's your name and what's your major? I would introduce myself and say that I was studying aerospace engineering, and they would go, "Wow, engineering? You must be so smart," which always felt really strange to me because, you know, computer scientists, they can like talk to robots, and sculptors can take a block of marble and make a human face out of it. You ask me, who's the real smart one there? Me, on the other hand, I would just take equations and theorems and concepts and apply them to engineering problems like tools to a car. And when I got stuck, there was always a manual like textbook or a YouTube video to help guide me through it. I feel like we all need 3 essential toolboxes. One for your car or house, one for your professional skills, and one for your life. You probably have the first one covered, or maybe your parents do. If you don't, you can go to Home Depot or Amazon and do your part as an American citizen and investor in our economy before your car breaks down the next time. But for your professional and your life toolboxes, that's where University of Florida steps in. You probably arrived with some professional skills already. You got into this program, of course. You probably knew a little bit of algebra, chemistry, calculus, and some physics. When you got here, your professors helped work with you to take the tools that you already had and make new ones. Through patient, creative, and passionate teaching, they helped you build the toolbox that you need and taught you how to really learn. At this point, your professional toolbox is probably overflowing thanks to the mechanical and aerospace engineering department. You know how to derive equations, program in MATLAB, calculate support reactions, take apart, build, design, test aircraft and engines, write a resume, and maybe even give a speech. It's great to have an overflowing professional toolbox. Throughout the rest of your career, you'll continue to add to it. Investing in your professional development is what's going to help you become the engineer that you were meant to be. But perhaps the most important tools that go in your toolbox go in your life toolbox. You've been building your life box for around 2 decades now. This is the toolbox where you have your family, your friends, and your general support network. Your ability to cook and clean, or maybe you didn't get those tools until you got to college. It wasn't until I got to college that I learned how to sort trash and actually recycle effectively. In college, I also learned how to push myself beyond my limits, both in a healthy and an unhealthy way. I ran my first ever fast half marathon, and I learned how to eat an entire box of pizza by myself. I developed a consistent yoga routine, and pulled some of my first all-nighters. I learned how to manage my time effectively to get work done and how to turn an assignment in at 11:59 the night that it was due. I learned how to really be a part of a team. When I was in high school, I was only ever in individual sports. I didn't really understand what it meant to achieve as a unit. When I got here, I realized that the best way for all of us to succeed was to take my time to teach and learn from my other teammates so that we could succeed together. I also learned how to be less task-oriented and to actually have fun in what I was doing and the people that I was with. When I was laying on the floor of the Wright's Union basement, 3 a.m. before a design manufacturing lab report was due, laughing over the Swampy Memes page with my team. I also learned that things don't always work out the way you want them to, and that's okay. My first freshman dorm roommate and I, we could not figure out how to live together, and she moved out halfway through our freshman year. I spent a couple hours crying over the fact that somehow I may have just ruined my entire college experience. But the girl who moved in after her became one of my best friends, and over time, even my first roommate and I learned how to get along, and we're actually friends now. I'm sure you can think back over your time here and compile a long list of lessons that you've learned from University of Florida since you moved out of your parents' house. In nearly every area of your life, you've grown and you've gained experience. You might not know it all yet, but you probably have a much better idea of who you are, where you want to go, and how you might change the world. Yes, you will change the world because you're an engineer. You can't exist in this world without finding a problem and trying to solve it. Maybe your own life feels really overwhelming right now, and it's hard to imagine changing the world from your bedroom. You're facing new challenges that you just didn't see coming. You're worried about the economy and how to virtually connect to your friends and how to wash your face mask. We all are. It's time for us to reach for our tools. You can start with time and stress management, and then maybe work your way up to designing the next mask or ventilator. You have everything you need to get through this crisis and the next one. You have 3 whole toolboxes, plus YouTube videos, and the friends, family, and faculty here at University of Florida to help you get through it. When you face your next challenge, take a deep breath and smile. You're a Gator engineer, and you have a tool to fix it. Thank you for a wonderful 4 years, and congratulations to all of our awards recipients and our graduates. Go Gators!
Fabulous. I want to thank Jennifer for being our keynote speaker. She's an inspiring student and a great example of what I think makes being a professor the best job I could imagine. Next, we're going to highlight one of our student teams, and it's going to be introduced by Dr. Sean Nimi.
Good evening. It's my pleasure to be introducing the Formula SAE team's video tonight. Last year, Formula SAE finished 25th out of 120 teams at Michigan International Speedway. Upon their return, the team took on the largest design undertaking in the last decade by switching the car from 13-inch wheels to 10-inch wheels. This necessitated a complete top-down redesign of nearly every system on the car, from suspension to aerodynamics to driver controls. After completing the vehicle this year just before spring break, the team managed to complete approximately 60 kilometers of driving to validate the new platform. Unfortunately, due to the onset of COVID-19, the team's competition has been moved to an entirely virtual format, and they will not be competing in the dynamic events this year. However, they are still working diligently to finalize all their design justifications and validate their designs based off of the data that they currently have. Next year, the team plans to take on even more large-scale design changes, working on designing a carbon fiber monocoque, as well as updating the active aerodynamics that are already in place on the car. Without further ado, Formula SAE.
So clear that our students have significant skill in video production. Next, we're going to move to the 2019-2020 Department Undergraduate Scholarship Awards. And these will be presented by Professor Bruce Carroll, Selena Robinson, and Shirley Robinson.
Welcome, everyone. This is Bruce Carroll, Undergraduate Coordinator for MAE. The John B. Boy U.S. Sugar Scholarship is named in honor of the former president of U.S. Sugar. This scholarship is awarded to undergraduates who are U.S. and Florida residents. The three recipients this year are Eric McKinnon, Isaiah Poole, and Niccolo Woodward. The Fife Family Foundation Scholarship was established in 1998. Robert J. Jim Fife received both his bachelor's and master's degrees in mechanical engineering from UF. This scholarship is awarded to outstanding junior or senior students in mechanical engineering, with preference to those from Northwest Florida, especially those from Lake City and West, especially Bay County. Three recipients this year are Joshua Owens, Mitchell Parker, and Madison Rodriguez. The Steve Hargrave Memorial Scholarship is awarded to an outstanding mechanical engineering student in memory of Steve Hargrave, who passed away in January of 1976 at age 21. Steve's brother, Scott, earned a bachelor's degree in 1978 and a master's degree in 1979 from UF. This year's recipient is Narotoma Esser. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Selena Robinson, academic advisor in MAE, and I'm here to announce the Eric Farber Scholarship Award winner. Dr. Farber joined UF in 1954 and served as director of the Solar and Energy Conservation Lab for 37 years before he retired in 1985. This award is for undergraduate or graduate students that have an interest in alternative energy research. This year's recipient is Cassie Dennison. Congratulations on winning this award. Good evening, it's Selena again, and I'm here to announce the Merton Hartman Jr. Scholarship winners. Mr. Hartman Jr. was an alumnus of mechanical engineering, and he is survived by his three children, Frank, Michael, and William, who also graduated from MAE. This year's recipients are Ozar Farid, and Kelly Fox. Congratulations on winning this award.
Next, we'll have Shirley Robinson and the McKinney Scholarship.
Good evening. I am Shirley Robinson, Academic Advisor in the Department of MAE, and I'm here to introduce this year's Sylvia McKinney Scholarship for 2020. Sylvia McKinney established this fund in 1993 for students studying in the field of aeronautical engineering. She was born on November 25, 1911, and she passed away in 2002 at the age of 90. This scholarship is awarded to deserving students in the Department of Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering. The recipients for this year are Luis Mendoza Sembrano, Andrew Oulette, Elizabeth Sanchez, Gabriel Stramatter, Alexandria Hatfield, and Alex Yegi. Congratulations.
We also had the great joy of inviting some of our scholarship donors to present the awards this year via video. Here we have the Albritton Scholarship.
Hello, my name is Paul Albritton, Brigadier General Paul Albritton. The reason that Pat and I started the scholarship was to show my appreciation for the education that I received at the University of Florida. It is a great honor to announce this year's outstanding student to the Brigadier General James P. and Edith P. Albritton Scholarship. This year, we recognize Christopher M. Thatcher.
Congratulations, Christopher. Next, we have the Peterson Women's Excellence Scholarship.
Hi, you guys. I'm Jill Peterson. I was teacher taught in the Department of Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering for 17 years. I started out in engineering fairly late. I'd already got a degree in basket weaving or something like that. And then I decided that I wanted to go into engineering. I went to my husband and told him, and he didn't pass out, he didn't freak out. He actually was really supportive, both emotionally and financially. He sent me through school to get my engineering degree. That was a huge advantage for me, and I want to try and pass that on to other women who want to go into this fascinating field. So that's the origin of the Robert and Jill Peterson Women's Excellence Award, and the winner this year is Robin Naderson. And so Robin, congratulations, huge congratulations. I hope it works out for you as well as it has for me. All right.
Next, I'd like to invite Professor Hitomi Greenslet as the advisor for our Pi Tau Sigma group to introduce their video.
Good evening. I'm Hitomi Greenslet, faculty advisor for Pi Tau Sigma. Pi Tau Sigma is the International Mechanical Engineering Honor Society. They foster scholarship, service, leadership, and integrity through activities across campus. This year, they have been very active in many ways. They were selected as the third most outstanding chapter out of 150 national chapters. Congratulations. They made an exciting video to share their activities with you. Please enjoy.
I stretch my hands out to the sky. We dance with monsters through the night.
Thank you for your support of this wonderful student group, Hitomi. Next, we're going to introduce our 2019-2020 Departmental Undergraduate Student Awards, and these are going to be presented by Mr. Michael Fitzgerald.
Good evening, everyone from the Emerald City. My name is Mike Fitzgerald, and I work as a member of our undergraduate advising team. This is my favorite event of the year as we celebrate the incredible talent and accomplishments of our MAE students. With everything that has happened these last few months, these students continue to inspire all of us. So I'm very happy to be with you here tonight. And although not as debonair as our host, I have the privilege of announcing three award categories. The first category is the 2019-2020 New University Scholars. The University Scholars is a university-wide program that introduces undergraduate students to academic research. It is a competitive process in which students are selected to work one-on-one with faculty on research projects. We have had a number of scholars in the past that have gone on to pursue graduate school and continue to conduct research under their faculty mentors. This year's recipients are Changxiao Liang with Dr. Huang, Joshua Valdivia with Dr. Nimi, Enrique Arenayas with Dr. Sheffy, Michaela Lam with Dr. Greenslet, and Gardner Camille with Dr. Huang. The Knox T. Millsaps Outstanding Undergraduate Technical Paper. It is challenging for undergraduate students to engage in research, and it is even more challenging for undergraduate students to produce a technical paper of scholastic quality. These students have demonstrated an appetite for original thought and an ability to contribute to academic discourse alongside professors in the field. Please join me in congratulating this year's outstanding technical paper recipients. Christian Perello, a mechanical engineering student with Dr. Roy, and Tanya Martin, an aerospace engineering student with Dr. Bevilacqua. The Knox Millsaps Outstanding Undergraduate Teaching Assistant Awards. Undergraduate teaching assistants serve very important roles, as many of them are engaged in lab courses or lecture courses with large class sizes with varying degrees of hands-on experience. They serve as valued facilitators and communicators between faculty and students. Tonight, we honor and thank the following recipients for their outstanding contributions as teaching assistants. This year's outstanding recipients are Marco Green with Dr. Shannon Ridgway and Caitlin Simmons with Dr. Abbott.
Thank you for the sound effects. Well done. Next, we've got, again, some of our benefactors awarding this year's Student Leadership Award.
Hello, my name is Peter Nicholas. The reason Bill Roto-Rooter, my college roommate and great friend of this day, started this endowment was because we believe that leadership has been such a big part of our success.
Hello, everybody. My name is Bill Roto-Rooter, Navy veteran and proud graduate of the University of Florida Aero Department. My friend Peter Nicholas, who's been my friend for life, and I stood up this award to honor people that embrace the idea of leadership and they understand the importance of leadership as we did throughout all our career, being able to connect and influence people and that being such an important piece of our success. So I am honored to announce this year's awardees for the Outstanding Leadership Award. This year, Emily Griffiths from Mechanical and Max Chern from Aero. Give them all a hand and thank you very much and congrats, guys. Go Gators.
Thanks. Have a great day and go Gators.
Next, we have our Sung and Yvonne Liu Outstanding Senior Awards.
My name is Jimmy Liu, and I have the great pleasure today to announce the recipients of the Sung and Yvonne Liu Outstanding Senior Award. This year's award is especially meaningful because my father passed away in March. He was a professor at the University of Florida for over 30 years, and he took great pride in teaching future engineering leaders in industry, academics, and research. This year's awards are for Elazar Tonef in mechanical engineering and Sage Drexler in aerospace engineering. Elazar and Sage's achievements and dedication to their fields are indeed impressive. I thank all of you for this opportunity to be a part of today's celebration, and I encourage all of you to get in touch with me if you'd like to know more about the really strong UF network in the San Francisco Bay Area and Silicon Valley. Go Gators!
Next, we'll have Sierra McVeigh introduce our undergraduate peer advising program.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sierra McVeigh, and I've had the pleasure of being the MAE Peer Advising Manager. Our peer advisors are upperclassmen who are available to undergraduate students for advice on matters including course loads, extracurricular involvement, professional development, and career opportunities, as well as activities occurring in the surrounding area and on campus. They offer advice based on their firsthand knowledge and experiences, and many of them have chosen their role because they wish they had known certain things when they first started out, and they want to ensure that their peers don't miss out on any opportunities. They're a very helpful, lively group, and we would just like to acknowledge their work and thank them for all they do.
Next, we'll have the 2019-2020 Departmental Graduate Student Awards, and these are going to be awarded by Professor Melissa Sartinoronat.
Hello, I'm the Graduate Faculty Coordinator for our large and vibrant MS and PhD programs. We have over 500 students, and it's my honor to recognize some of their outstanding achievements today. The Glenn and Deborah Renwick Engineering Scholarship is awarded to outstanding master's students who demonstrate a strong background in academics and research. These scholarships are supported by UF Industrial Systems and Engineering alumnus and industry leaders, Glenn Renwick and his wife, Deborah Renwick. This year's recipients are Diego Gordon, who's doing research with Dr. Sheffi, and Zhejiang Peng, who's doing research with S.A. Sharif. The Knox Millsaps Outstanding Graduate Assistant Awards. For these awards, a teaching assistant plays an important part of the education process at an institution such as UF. These students not only help to educate students, but in turn gain a valuable skill set as well. This year's recipients are Fei Shuang, who's a TA for mechanical design with Dr. Ifentis. And we had a tie actually. And Kang Jae Lee, who is a TA for thermodynamics, which was taught also by Professor Benitez. Congratulations. The Daniel A. Honig Family Graduate Fellowship. This fund was established in 2012 by Diane C. Honig in memory of her husband, Daniel. Daniel graduated from the University of Florida in 1957 with a bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering. He was also a lawyer and graduated from the George Washington School of Law in 1975. Daniel passed away in 2001. This year's recipient is Bianca Brown. Congratulations, Bianca. The Richard W. Goodrum Memorial Fellowship. This memorial fellowship that honors Mr. Goodrum, for this fellowship, preference is given to veterans of the US military and or children of veterans of the US military. This year's recipient is Kevin Groth. Congratulations, Kevin. Student Graduate Research Awards. These awards are for students who have made outstanding research contributions in their PhD studies. They've written many journal articles, presented at prestigious conferences, and made cutting edge contributions. The recipients of this year's award are Trushant Patel, who works with Dr. Miller for our TSFD division. Shidits Upaday, who works with Dr. Subhash in our SMDM division. And Federica Zegers, who works with Dr. Dixon in our DSC division. Our 2019 graduate research fellowships are also recognized. For these awards, students compete against the very best PhD students across the country. These prestigious awards recognize the strengths of these students and help distinguish our institution. Our MAE students have made us proud with these prestigious national fellowships. The recipients are Brendan Allen, who works with Dr. Dixon, Jack Famiglietti, who works with Dr. Sawyer, Min Chao Lei, who works with Dr. Fan, Amkar Mulakar, who works with Dr. Bevilacqua, and Dennis Parnell, who works with Dr. Sheplak.
Next, Dr. Karen Ellers will introduce a video by our Graduate Student Council.
Good evening and welcome to our virtual celebration of achievement. As the advisor for the Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering Graduate Student Council, I'm so pleased to acknowledge the contributions of the GSC membership and the dedication of the GSC Executive Board. Today, we recognize an organization that has grown to signify academic excellence and commitment to service. The GSC seeks to better the quality of graduate education, facilitate research and professional opportunities, and to improve the overall graduate experience. They provide and promote social engagement and networking with fellow students, which includes our annual bowling tournament and our qualification exam review. And finally, they facilitate MAE events such as junior preview, spring visit, and new student orientation. The Graduate Student Council is so much more than the voice of graduate education, and I hope you enjoyed viewing this small snapshot of the wonderful programs and events and camaraderie that is the MAE GSC family. I also have the pleasure today to announce the Paul and Mary Jane Halyard Engineering Excellence Endowment Awards, established by MAE alumnus Paul Halyard and his wife. This award recognizes achievements in teaching, research, technology, or service activities. Our congratulations this year to Thomas Linehan and Nicholas Scholl. Thanks, Thomas and Nick, for all of your contributions.
Back to Professor Santanurinat for the Best Dissertation Awards.
PhD dissertations are the written culmination of years of hard work by each student. They are filled with technical discoveries and personal achievements. I'm proud to recognize three of our best dissertations this year. The recipients are Baswati Chowdhury, who works, her advisor is Dr. Subrata Roy for the TSFD division. Courtney Rouse, who works with Dr. Dixon for our DSC division, and Brandon Whitbeck, who works with Dr. Spirot for our SMDM division. And with that, I'd like to provide a great round of applause for all our graduate winners.
Yay! Thank you, Melissa. Next, we'll have our AIAA video introduced by Professor Richard Lin.
Now I would like to acknowledge another group of students. In this case, it's the student chapter of the American Institute of Aeronautics and Astronautics, or AIAA. The goals of this student chapter is to provide opportunities for students to get involved and get experiences in all the many fields within aerospace engineering. We had a really great group of officers this year and members with an exceptionally active and energetic president in Max Chern, that led the way in providing an array of opportunities ranging from design teams to community service, hosting invited speakers, up to professional conferences and interactions. Let's take a look.
Wait. choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win, and the others too.
And for those who didn't realize it, we do have a liquid-fueled rocket propulsion team in MAE. Next, we're going to move to the 2019-2020 Departmental Faculty and Staff Awards. And these are going to be presented by Professors Peter Ifyu and Norman Fitzcoy.
Good evening. I'm honored to present awards for some of the very best faculty in our department. These were selected based on student feedback and a combination of the Honors and Awards Committee and the administration. With so many great professors and lecturers in our department, the selection process is always a challenge. The first award is the MAE Teacher of the Year Award. This is the longest running faculty award presented in our department. The award recognizes tenure and tenure track faculty for excellence in the classroom. The selection is based on student feedback, exit interviews, and teacher evaluations. This year's recipient is Professor Douglas Sparrott. Dr. Sparrott joined our faculty in 2015. He recently taught mechanics and materials on the undergraduate level, and then principles of fracture mechanics, as well as computational nanomechanics and nanomaterials on the graduate level. Please join in recognizing Professor Sparrott as the MAE Teacher of the Year. Congratulations, Dr. Sparrott. This year, two new awards for teaching were recently created for lecturers and instructors by three of our very best teachers. The awards were created by Teresa Benitez, who won Teacher of the Year Award last year, Jonathan Brooks, who is one of the most popular instructors in our department, and our chair, Scott Banks, who was Teacher of the Year in 2012. The first of these new awards is the Instructional Faculty of the Year Award, Excellence in Education. This year's recipient is Mike Braddock for his passionate and thorough approach to teaching our design and manufacturing lab. Mike created the lab content from scratch and built up the lab space with the full support of our administration. His class is the envy of many of our peer institutions. He consistently receives high marks on his evaluations and student exit interviews, even though students often say his class is one of the hardest and time-consuming classes they ever take. Please join us in celebrating, or congratulating, Mike Braddock for his excellence in teaching. Congratulations, Mike. The second new award for lecturer instructor positions is the Instructional Faculty of the Year Award, Excellence in Teaching Innovation. This year's recipient is Shannon Ridgway for his innovative approach over the years in the development and implementation of laboratory experiments in the Mechanics and Materials Lab and the Dynamics Control Lab. He's been able to provide fresh content in a non-optimal situation with low budgets, small lab space, and hundreds of students each semester. This spring has been especially challenging, and he provided meaningful experiments when students were actually sent off campus. Additionally, Shannon co-authored a book with Professor Subhash titled Mechanics and Materials Laboratory Course. Please join in congratulating Shannon Ridgway for his innovations in teaching. Congratulations, Shannon.
I will shake the pom-pom and thank all of our dedicated teachers and instructors for the job they do and the enthusiasm that they bring to an excellent educational program. As I mentioned earlier, Jan Rocky retired in the fall and passed away shortly after that, but left a profound legacy of service to the department with us. And so it's a great honor that this year we now name the Outstanding Staff Member of the Year Award in her honor. So to introduce the inaugural MAE Jan Rocky Outstanding Staff Award, we have Jan's three daughters.
We are honored to be able to present the Jan Rocky Outstanding Member of the Year Award. The recipient for this award is chosen based on hard work and dedication, just as our mother has exemplified over the decades.
Mom recently retired after 43 years of service, and over that time served 7 department chairs while at Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering.
This year, the first recipients of this award embodies characteristics of our mother's work ethic. Congratulations to Jeremy Hall.
Congratulations, Jeremy. We're so grateful for the work that you do, the innovation that you've brought to our graduate program and graduate student services. It's fitting that we can offer you the inaugural Jan Rocky Outstanding Staff Award of this year. Next, we'll have Professor Norman Fitzcoy recognize 2 of our outstanding and longest serving staff members.
Good evening. I'm Norman Fitzcoy, and it is my pleasure this evening to recognize these 2 ladies for their services to the University of Florida and specifically to the MAE department. Combined, these ladies have over 75 years of dedicated service to the University of Florida. First, let me start with Ms. Shirley Robinson, who joined UF in 1980 as a staff member in the College of Pharmacy. In March of 1987, Shirley transferred to the then Department of Aerospace Engineering, Mechanics, and Engineering Sciences, Ames, where she worked with both graduate and undergraduate students. I met Shirley in 1991. In 2002, the Ames department merged with the ME department to form the current MAE department. Since the merger, Shirley has been working exclusively with undergraduate students in both degree programs. Second is Ms. Selena Robinson, no relationship to Shirley, who joined UF in 1984 as a staff member in the Department of Anthropology. Selena transferred to the MAE department in 2005, working also exclusively with undergraduate students in both programs. Their responsibilities span a broad spectrum of activities from registration to drop ed, to petitions for course substitutions, to course coordination and planning for a future semester, to, you get it, the list is just too long to mention all their activities. Suffice it to say, they take care of our undergraduate students and faculty. Collectively, these ladies have guided, mentored, and nurtured thousands of students, ensuring that they successfully transfer through their college careers. Throughout their many years of service to students, Shirley and Selena have interacted with many different types of students and parents, including those helicopter parents who demand to know why their daughters and or sons missed crucial assignments and may or may not graduate on time. However, during these interactions, Shirley and Selena have always been the consummate professional, providing service with a smile. Religiously, at this time of the semester, we're reminded by Shirley, our grade agator coordinator, of the deadline for grade submissions, along with reminders, aka threats, of what happens if we don't complete grade submissions on time. I should note that these threats have become somewhat kinder as they are now in green colored text as opposed to the boldface red text of earlier times. I'm sure by the time this event is over, there will be an email in our inboxes reminding us of Monday's grade submission deadline. Shirley and Selena, thanks for your many years of service to the University of Florida and to the MAE department. Your contributions to the department's undergraduate academic programs are greatly appreciated. The success of our students and faculty would not be possible without your tireless efforts. At this point, it is customary to say something along the lines of congrats on achieving this milestone in your careers. and looking forward to many more years of dedicated service. However, after 75 years of collective service, a more appropriate statement would be best wishes on your next adventures. So on behalf of our MAE colleagues, thanks for your service. And as they would say in Jamaica, walk well.
I'm happy to echo Professor Fitzcoy's comments and thank Shirley Robinson and Selena Robinson for their many years of service, their enormous help in all that we do, and our gratitude for all that they have done for us. Next, I will introduce a video by our Gatorloop student group. Our Gatorloop team were semifinalists in the 2019 SpaceX Hyperloop Pod competition, among the top 50 of over 1,500 international teams, or the top 5%. In 2020, they successfully completed their prototype design in only 8 weeks after delivering a formal design review to our MAE faculty. They achieved a team roster of 50 students from multiple areas of study, including mechanical, electrical, computer, industrial, and business. And they are a prolific source of talent, engineering talent, for employers, with Gatorloop alumni now working at companies like SpaceX, Siemens, Tesla, and many others. My previous comment on the expertise of our students in video production. The next part of our ceremony is what many of us consider the highlight of our awards program. That is the awarding of the MAE Outstanding Alumnus Awards. This is the highest recognition that we award our alumni, identifying individuals who have achieved distinction in their lives through their professional practice and who exemplify for us all the characteristics of great engineers. Each awardee will receive a custom Gator statue with the Outstanding Alumnus Award inscription. Because we are not meeting in person this year, we have invited our 2019-2020 MAE Outstanding Alumni to join us at next year's MAE Spring Awards Banquet. If you need us to mail it to you now, we will, but we hope to present it to you in person next year. As notable examples of what our students go on to achieve, we believe it's entirely fitting that each MAE Outstanding Alumnus Awardee is inducted by an outstanding current student. Thus, we will now hear from 5 current students introducing the 2019-2020 class of MAE Outstanding Alumnus Awardees.
Hello, everyone. My name is Max Chern, and I have the pleasure tonight of introducing Mr. Carlos Bravo. Mr. Bravo has over 30 years of experience in business, technology, and real estate development. After an early semi-retirement at the age of 39, he has remained active as a private investor and strategic advisor to established corporations and startup companies. He has served on the board of directors of Pacific Airport Group, Embry-Riddle University, EagleNet Ventures, and Carra House Development, and on the executive advisory boards of the Daytona Beach International Airport and the Embry-Riddle Technology Research Park. After graduating from the University of Florida with a bachelor's degree in aerospace engineering, Mr. Bravo attended Northwestern University's law and business schools. He co-founded IIT Holding Incorporation, a global management consulting and systems integration company that specialized in PeopleSoft integrations at Fortune 500 companies, and he drove the negotiations for the merger of this company with US Internet Working, a company that pioneered internet-based outsourcing of enterprise applications and subscription-based e-commerce. Prior to this, Mr. Bravo also held several technology management and systems design positions, and he was recognized in the industry as an expert in business process re-engineering. He founded his own venture, Bravo International Corporation, which was a manufacturer of sporting goods and toys and a global commodities trader. He also served as principal and vice president of Comdisco Incorporation's business process consulting venture, which was a startup funded by Comdisco to initiate the company's path into distributed system services. The Mechanical and Aerospace Department is proud to honor Mr. Carlos Bravo with the Outstanding Alumnus Award. Let's have a round of applause for Mr. Carlos Bravo.
Thank you, Max, and congratulations, Carlos. I very much look forward to meeting you at next year's ceremony and taking further sartorial tips from your fine style as exhibited in the photo on the slide. Next, we'll have Isaiah Hendrick inducting Dr. Marianne Francois.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Isaiah Hendrick, and I'm the president of the University of Florida's chapter of the Society of Automotive Engineers. Tonight, I have the honor of introducing Dr. Marianne Francois. Dr. Francois conducted her undergraduate engineering education at École Polytechnique Féminine in France with a degree in engineering physics. She attended Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University for her Master of Science in Aerospace Engineering, before coming to the University of Florida for her PhD in aerospace engineering. While at the University of Florida, Dr. Francois wrote her dissertation on the computation of drop dynamics with heat transfer. After receiving her PhD, Dr. Francois left for the Los Alamos National Laboratory, where she started as a postdoctoral research assistant, working on numerical methods for incompressible interfacial flow that are still critical for the laboratory's casting and manufacturing missions today. From this foundation, Dr. Francois has become an internationally recognized expert in computational fluid dynamics, multi-phase and multi-material flow, and numerical methods. Her contributions have placed her in numerous leadership roles in Los Alamos' weapons program, in addition to assisting the National Nuclear Security Administration and the Department of Energy. Dr. Francois has led as a deputy group leader of the Fluid Dynamics and Solid Mechanics Group at Los Alamos, group leader of the Computational Physics Division's Methods and Algorithms Group, and project leader of the Advanced Simulation and Computing Mix and Burn Project. Most recently, Dr. Francois has served as program manager of the ASC Physics and Engineering Models Program, overseeing 100 scientists and a $30 million budget across 7 physics projects. Dr. Francois has also put a considerable effort into her community, providing aerospace education to K-12 programs and by serving in the Civil Air Patrol. MAE is proud to honor Dr. Francois by presenting her with the Outstanding Alumnus Award.
Thank you, Isaiah, and congratulations, Marianne. We very much look forward to welcoming you here in Gainesville next year for your real in-person indoctrination into the MAE Outstanding Alum Society. Next, we'll have Uzair Farid inducting Michael Gunger.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Uzair Farid, and I'm an undergraduate student studying mechanical engineering. Tonight, I have the honor of introducing Mr. Michael Gunger. Mr. Gunger grew up in Bridgeport, Connecticut, as part of a large family with a farming background. From a young age, he learned the importance of hard work. Upon graduating high school, Mr. Gunger joined the United States Air Force, where he served two tours during the Vietnam War and went on to join a reserve special operations group. His last combat operation was Desert Storm, where he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross. Mr. Gunger left active duty to pursue a mechanical engineering degree from the University of Florida. He graduated in 1982 and began working at the Air Force Research Lab at the Eglin Air Force Base. At the research lab, Mr. Gunger specialized in simulating transient high-rate processes associated with the development of conventional weapons. In 1988, Mr. Gunger went on to receive his master's degree from the UFMAE department as well. In 1989, Mr. Gunger left the Air Force Research Lab to join Orlando Technology, Inc., which is currently part of General Dynamics, where he developed new models for the ignition and growth of detonable materials. As part of this effort, Mr. Gunger became a regular contributor to a series of Gordon conferences in this area. He has served twice as the chair of the Classified Ballistics, Bombs, and Warheads Conference and has published over 20 papers in various symposiums. In 2007, Mr. Gunger started his own company, Gunger Engineering. It performs consulting work for all branches of the DoD, as well as other defense-related departments. Although his office is located in Niceville, Florida, Mr. Gunger now resides in Brentwood, Tennessee, with his wife, Pamela. The UFMAE department is proud to honor Mr. Michael Gunger for our Outstanding Alumnus Award.
Thank you, Uzair, and congratulations, Michael. Again, we look forward to meeting you in person next year. Next, we'll have Sage Drexler introducing Dr. Ramesh Mary.
Good evening. My name is Sage Rose Drexler, and I have the distinct honor to introduce Dr. Ramesh Mary. Dr. Mary received both his master's and PhD in engineering mechanics from the University of Florida in 1991 and 1995, respectively. His area of expertise has been stent concept development using structural FEA, arterial biomechanics, stent fatigue characterization, acute bench test development, and related global regulatory interactions. He describes that witnessing the speedy recovery and improved quality of life for a patient after being treated with the minimally invasive implants is immensely satisfying to him. He began his career at Advance USA in computational modeling and analysis and remained there from 1996 to 2001. For the past 19 years, he has led a distinguished career in the area of vascular stents, first with coronary stents and peripheral stents at Johnson & Johnson from 2001 to 2019, and currently under vascular stents for stroke treatment with Medtronic. While at Johnson & Johnson, Dr. Mari's positions included Engineering Fellow, Director of Computational Analysis Group, Project Lead for Self-Expanding Stents, and Director of Advanced Engineering Group. He was awarded Johnson & Johnson's prestigious Philip Hoffman Award for Outstanding Research, the Standards of Leadership Award in 2012 and 2014, the Six Sigma Team Award, and the Technical Contributor of the Year Award in 2017. Dr. Mari is currently working as a distinguished engineer at Medtronic. Recently relocating from the Bay Area to the town of Mission Viejo near Irvine, Dr. Mari is joined by his wife and two children. Please join me in congratulating Dr. Mari on receiving the MAE Outstanding Alumnus Award.
Thank you, Sage, and congratulations, Ramesh. We too look forward to meeting you here next year. Next, we have Joseph Mirt introducing Sean Martin.
Hello, my name is Joseph Mirt, and it is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Sean Martin today. Mr. Martin is currently a senior engineer for the United States Special Operations Command. The last 33 years of his career have been spent supporting projects for the U.S. Special Operations Command and the Naval Surface Warfare Center. Mr. Martin's contributions have awarded him the Joint Civilian Service Commendation Award for achievements in the Undersea Program Office, as well as the ASME Duncan Leadership Award, among others. Following his graduation from the University of Florida with a Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering in 1986, Mr. Martin began his career as a mechanical engineer with the Naval Surface Warfare Center. His work as the lead engineer for multiple projects led to the production and fielding of newly developed military technologies and the award of a U.S. patent. Following this, Mr. Martin joined the U.S. Special Operations Command as an engineer shortly before earning his master's degree in national security and strategic studies from the Naval War College. Since his return from academic sabbatical in 2006, Mr. Martin served as a chief engineer for the Tactical Assault Light Operator Suit. Additionally, Mr. Martin worked as the project and technical manager for many contracts and projects, including a dry combat submersible for Naval Special Warfare and the Small Business Innovation Research Program. Mr. Martin maintains his position as a senior engineer with the U.S. Special Operations Command in Tampa, Florida today. UFMAE is proud to honor Mr. Martin for our Outstanding Alumnus Award. Please join me in congratulating Mr. Martin.
Thank you, Joseph, and congratulations, Sean. I'd like to repeat that we'll look forward at next year's award banquet to honoring again the 2019-2020 Outstanding Alumnus Award winners. You inspire us all, and you provide visible example for our many students on the kinds of profound impacts that you can have on the world with a mechanical or aerospace engineering degree. I want to congratulate all of our scholarship and award winners tonight. I'd like to shake the pom-pom and show the enthusiasm that we unfortunately can't accompany with hundreds of people standing and cheering for you. But your efforts and achievements have inspired us all. Tonight's presentation took a lot of effort from a number of people, and I'd especially like to recognize the efforts of Melanie D. Prospero, Carolyn Howard, Zach Savisky, and Jeremy Hall, who gathered and organized the content and prepared the materials and technology for our event. I'd also like to recognize Professors Peter Ifew and Jim Trainum, and our colleagues serving on the Honors and Awards Committee for evaluating nominations for many of our awards. Similarly, our undergraduate and graduate advising groups play a huge role in identifying and selecting students for recognition. So special thanks to Michael Fitzgerald, Shirley Robinson, Selena Robinson, Sierra McVeigh, and Professor Bruce Carroll for our undergraduates, and to Dr. Karen Ellers, Jeremy Hall, and Professor Melissa Sartinoronat for our graduate awards. I thank everyone for participating in our awards ceremony. I offer congratulations and applause to all of our honorees, and I wish you all a safe, healthy, and productive summer. Good night, and go Gators.